Before I start the new topic, I think there is only about 1.5 lecture remaining for the linear programming. Then we shall start transportation problems. So let me pause for a moment and ask if you people have any kind of questions, doubts, comments, or whatsoever. If you want to ask anything. Do you want to ask anything? Hello? Am I audible or not?
You are audible, sir.
So you don't want to ask anything? Acha, tell me how have you done in the quiz? I have evaluated about maybe 60-70 answer scripts, and I see that majority is getting only in single digit. Sometimes it is like 5-6 or below that, sometimes 8-9. What went wrong? You have any suggestions, comments, anything?
Sir, there were internships going on, so we lost track of starting one or two classes, and then it became difficult to cover up. So that's why we were not able to practice out enough for the quiz.
Oh, okay.
Hello, sir.
Ha ha.
Sir, I felt that the quiz was slightly lengthy.
Because I gave actually 50% of the questions were 30 marks question. I thought giving more questions will give you more choices, whatever you want to write. But I mean, do you want me to, for a 20 mark quiz, you want me to give 20 mark questions only? That can be done also.
30 marks is fine, sir. But for the first time, we have confused it. Like, we have been shifting from one question to one question. Let's try this. And we have lost time.
Yeah, that is true. I understand. When we see quite a lot of questions in the exam, then we shift from here to there. And then, and it is not a normal practice in exams that somebody gives you this many questions, I mean, with this many choices. Normally, I give so that, see, exam questions are exam questions. If I am stuck and I am unable to solve, then that is it. So if I have some one or two extra questions, then I may not get stuck in the other questions. So that is why I give extra questions. But I do feel that the time was a little less. I think I would be maybe giving more time so that you can do. But the only problem is that few of the students, when I say few, it is actually few of the students are copying each other's answers. I was amazed to see few of the answers are like matching so much that the English words are mathematical things would match. That is expected. Even the English words are matching, the adjectives and other things. So some of them I could figure out that these are like copy. So I have taken some hard steps there. The reason I could not give more time is that more time given more time, people will tend to, WhatsApp each other's answer script, and that's what students do when they have more time. So, but majority of the students, they have answered on their own. They have not looked at the other things. Those which I could figure out, actually, they are, copies of each other. There I have deducted -5. And this is one time. Only for this time it is -5. I would request you don't do that. I give you more time, fine. You want more time, I can give you 2 hours also. But if you promise me that you won't do this, you won't copy anybody else's thing. If you do that, I can give more time. I don't have a problem. I am trying to explain you. It is my pleasure to see that whatever you have understood, you are answering using that and you are scoring. But just because, just to score some few more marks, if you are trying to copy from somebody else, that is not a good thing. So, I will not make it public, nor I will complain it to any higher authority or anything. Few of the answer script, looking at them, I could figure out they have copied. So that's what -5 I have deducted. And so only those students will know that I have deducted -5 from them. And if you simply promise me that you are not going to repeat the same mistake again, I can give that five marks back also. That is not a problem. I am not going to tell it to anybody. No higher authority. But it is up to you. You don't want to admit, still then, it is impossible to have, in a paragraph, it is very difficult to have the English words matching. In the same style, same this thing. So that should not, that shows that, when we start copying, our brains do not work. We simply copy. The hand works, eye works, but brain doesn't work. So that's how it is. Anyway, some of you are having that kind of practice. So in order to, I was saying this, that why I could not give more time. I could not give more time. Normally, if it is offline classroom test, I would have given you up to maybe 2 hours or something. I would have said, you do as long as you think you are able to answer, probably take your time. I would have done that. But here I am unable to do. So, because some of you involved in this bad practices, get involved in that. So that is why. Were the questions difficult? The first question wasn't difficult. It was straight away asking you to whatever you have learned. It was straight away asking you to do this, do that. That is what the first question was designed. Directly, whatever was discussed, I was asking that only. Only the last question was a bit new. That is why it had more marks. But I am happy to see that one or two students have done that really nicely. And some of you have really answered the question number 2 and question number 3 in very nice way. So when I am, this is not announced, but I do that in every year, every time I teach. Whenever I like some part of your answer, so I normally give some 1 mark bonus or something like that. This is very, very normal with me. So some of you have got bonus marks. just because of your writing. I felt happy with the way you have written. So some of you have got bonus mark. But unfortunately, I felt bad also while deducting that 5 marks. But what to do? I mean, if I catch that and do not punish, then that's not my duty. I mean, it's against the duty. So that is why. Am I going very speedily or something like that?
Sir, for in the exam, with respect to time, what I felt was that for the first question, it wasn't difficult, but going through all of the calculations, making sure there were no mistakes, so a plus minus sign here and there, that was true. What took a lot of time for us, because
agree. My only fear, like if you people, I mean, I can see there is one class representative in CSE, one in MNC. If you people can have a meeting and just promise me that you people will not involve in this looking at each other's answers, I can give more time. See, there is no way that I can ensure that you are not copying or copying. Those things cannot be ensured. There are n number of ways. I put n number of ways, then you will find n plus one another way to cheat. That's not the thing. When you people are honestly saying no, we will not do, then I can give more time. If you can do that, I will be happy to give more time. And it is true that that question number one, if you do 1 hour, I think was not, it was really, really tight by putting 1 hour. It was tight actually.
Sir, can you provide the solutions or answers to the exercises, like so that we can practice something of, like, because after solving them and we do not know the answer, then we are not sure whether my concept was right or wrong.
No, that I cannot provide publicly, but if you have solved something and you send it to me, I can send the tell you, I can guide you, this is the way to go. Or if you are really stuck, a group of students, you are stuck at an exercise, then some exercise if you demand together, then I can post it also publicly. But some of them, if you have progressed, this is how, this much we have done, what to do next, that also I can help. But like, I cannot give the solution just like that. It would also mean that you have not at all tried and I am just giving the solution. It is not going to really help you that way. But if you can show me the progress, I can definitely give.
Sir, instead, can you suggest a book that we can do it through?
Books. The Combos book, whatever books are mentioned, the Leuenberger and then all those books are okay. I mean, you will find many of the, I mean, all standard concepts and all standard methods, they are all there. The extra explanations that I provide you, that is not there in any book. It is from my own experience. So for that, I cannot give you, suggest you any book. I haven't seen yet, but the standard concepts and everything, those things you will find. Actually, whatever you are seeing in these notes, they are from my experience. Many of the exercises are from my own experience, my own creation. And few of the explanations that you proofs, two theorems and different explanations, that has come to me when I have gone through many different books. So these are good books. If you see this Leuenberger or Combos book for practicing, the typical simplex method, or transportation problem or a dual simplex method. So those questions, like those kind of questions you will find from there. Or even the theoretical question that the general separation between two non-empty disjoint convex sets, that was question number 3. That is a theorem. If you see Cambo's book or some other book, you will find it as a theorem from here. But not the fourth question. Fourth question wasn't from any book or anything. Even the second question I learned when I was a few years back discussing with a professor, and the professor from game theory from Ohio State, I think, University of Illinois. So he was from there. So he said, oh, do you know this is what will be a vertex? So then I realized, it comes easily. So that is how things are from many things are from experience.
Okay, sir. Thank you,
sir. Like we are just listening to your lectures, but we are not getting the perspective how to approach a problem and why this particular theorem will be useful in future. Something like this. We are not getting the perspective.
Before I discuss anything, I always write a paragraph and I always tell why it is important and where is it is going to be used. That I do. And even then you are asking means, I am not getting your question. Can you tell again what you are asking?
Like in 6th and 7th lectures, we have many theorems and those theorems will be useful to state that vertex will be an optimal solution for some objective function. So
we
will get to know about that thing only if we study the further lectures. But how do we know, like, if we are having a theorem, like why should we study it and how to apply that?
And here you will have to trust the instructor a little bit. You have to trust that I am not going to tell you a theorem which I am not going to use. Or so normally the instructors will tell you something just because, simply because it is going to be used at a later date. So that is how it is. I remember this is the similar type of questions were asked to us when we were teaching this 101. Students would ask, why again? We already know limit continuity. Why again you are teaching us? Why you are troubling us? And the same question was asked in complex analysis. Why again doing this? What is the necessity? But later on, as we move ahead, we find out many applications of them. So they are in the course, and many standard, all over the world, people put these things in the course. It is simply because, all of us, we really know that these are useful. So some bit of trust probably would be required. and you can also assume ki ye humko pareshan kar raha hai. Actually, so before we come to the later lectures, it is difficult to tell you. So as far as possible, I try to tell ki where these things are going to be used, why this is important. And normally I try to tell these things. But beyond that, telling the exact application before I reach to that stage will be difficult. For example, in this quiz, you would have realized that we have found now 4 different ways to answer the same question. So then you feel satisfied. Okay, so we have learned this kind of things. Okay, so that is how. And this course optimization technique is a purely very, very practical type of course. Why don't you people, if you have any kind of doubt or anything, why don't you people ask me then and there? In between the lecture also, you people can ask me. You can stop me and ask me to, if you are not following something or I went very quickly through a theorem or something, you can simply ask me to repeat it. Just repeat the whole proof. You can demand that. You don't do that too often, otherwise everything will be delayed, but you can do that. I won't mind it. Like, my total aim is that, see, if I am telling all these things, spending my time, and finally you do not understand it, then it is all waste. So instead of that, I would like to invest 10 more minutes so that you understand, and so that it helps you in the exam or in a later date also. Achha, while these lectures are going on, are you people able to follow it or you do not follow it?
Sir, sometimes it is moving too fast.
So then you should ask me, go slow, please, go slow, or repeat this one, please, again. If that is no problem. That is what you would have, actually, that is what I would have done if I was actually in the physical classroom. Then I don't have to ask you. By looking at your face, I would realize, no, the students are not following. So let me give another example and illustrate why it is happening. But here what is happening is that I cannot see your face, and if I turn the video on, then this internet will not cooperate. So it is not really possible. So in that case, you please do not hesitate to ask me to repeat, but do not do that like deliberately. Do it honestly. If you are not following, then you please ask. And I will try to, keep your request as far as possible. That you are free to do that. And see, there are so many exercises as you people are asking. If I have given you, say, 60 exercises I have written, and then you want me to, you choose randomly some whatever 15 exercises, you say, like, sir, we tried this, and provide the solution. I can actually discuss it with you also. Unfortunately, we do not have any tutorial kind of class over here. Otherwise, we could have discussed some exercises here. Some of them I do tell, which involves some imagination, a distant kind of imagination, like the one in the stochastic matrices that you have to relate it to bipartite graphs. So that would have been difficult. So that I mentioned in the class notes. I mentioned it in the lecture itself. If people can ask me let's say weekly 4-5 exercises, whatever you want. You tell, sir, question number, exercise number this, exercise number that, these things we tried, you give them, and then I will give the solution. I will provide the solution. I do not mind. I have given the exercise with the intention that you solve it, you learn. That is my intention. If you have solved and you are not sure, or if you are unable to solve, in both the cases, I can supply the solution. I have no problem. You can ask me. Your class representatives, they can easily coordinate with me via email, saying that these are the, for this week, these are the questions. This So the numbers are given, this 14.1 or 13.5, this exercise, that exercise, how to do this one, how to do that one. I can do. But provided you people are interested and you people have time. The problem is that most of the time you people get busy in something else, or for some reason you do not give 1 hour time every lecture day. The simple policy is like 1 hour time every lecture day after the lecture is over. That should keep you up to date. But if you, I mean, put them as like keep them as backlog and think that okay, before exam I will read and understand everything, then what my experience is, it has always been a bit difficult for the students. Now you people have more other things, internship or whatever, some other things are there or not?
Yes, sir. Internship season is going on right now.
It is also going on?
Yes, sir.
And how long it will go?
Right now we have spot 2 going on, but I don't know the duration.
Sir, I think it will continue on December, the phase 1. And after that, there will be phase 2 as well. So, will continue throughout the semester.
It will be difficult then. If people have to give some time, and that is also important. I am not saying that is not important. That is also important. This one is also important. Managing this. I think the best solution is that you people, together you have a meeting and you promise me that you will not copy from anybody's answer script. If you can simply promise me that one, then I can keep more time. And that definitely would help. You take your time, but you write honestly. Whatever you think you can do, you take your time and you do. And that is how. And also, you are not supposed to look at the lecture notes during that exam period, lecture notes or video. You prepare yourself. Once you are ready, look at the question paper, solve it. So I can give more time, but provided you people really, really, honestly cooperate with me. That I can do. I can give like mid-sem, I can give more time. And it will take time. Of course, it will take time that you have to do the calculations, and it is going to be because these tables and other things. The next exam, it will be more because then you will be writing 4-5 tables. Okay, but like solve this by simplex method, then some 4, 5, or 6, 7 tables will come. You will have to do that. Okay, so time will be required. But then if you solve yourself, and it will not take me much of a time to copy what you have written. So sharing and copying would be like possible. That you have to stop. And you ask me some mathematical question now. What doubts you have? You are never asking me any doubts. Or ask me to repeat something if you want me to. Or otherwise I will start. I mean today's thing I will start. I can tell more things. Shall we start some new discussion? This dual simplex method.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I just wanted to ask if you have any clue about when offline classes will begin.
No clue till now.
Okay, sir.
It is not yet discussed. not yet discussed in any meeting. We have not got any notice, but we are also hoping that it will start soon. And by soon, definitely it is not within 1 month, because we have no idea. Otherwise, we would have been informed. So I have no idea, actually. I would be happy if people come back. At least then I can be a little bit slow by looking at your faces. So I can realize what I am telling, what is new to you. By like, if I tell something and then look at your faces, I can realize. But here I am unable to realize. I am just speaking to myself or something like that. Okay, so anyway, people
ask. Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
I missed the first 2-3 minutes, so you might have mentioned it, but when will you be giving the marks for the quiz?
Right now, I think I have evaluated about maybe 60 something this thing. I am doing it on my own, actually. On the PDF, I am marking this thing. So I decided not to take help of anybody. So therefore, this whole week will go. Maybe in the next week sometime, I will be able to give that.
Okay, sir.
And out of those 60, 70, whatever I have evaluated, the highest I remember has gone up to 14.5. And I think another is 14, but the rest of them are all single digit. Only two answer scripts that has gone 114 and 114.5. Rest of them are all single digit till now. So I do not know. I mean, maybe like we'll decide if the score is not high, then I will assume that the quiz total mark was 15 or something like that. And then though quiz total mark was 20, right? So I will assume if the highest mark is not going beyond 15, then I will assume that the quiz total mark was 15. Then 5 extra marks I can shift to some other exam. So then you have chances to score more there. I mean, suppose that you have scored, let's say 9, instead of your score like being 9 out of 20, it would be then 9 out of 15. That way it would be a little better, like you will have more chance to score later. Like I am trying to do like all these things. I only want that if people score more, but not unethically. You score more, but just due to what you have learned and using your own this thing, not by unfair means. So that is what I want. Anyway, since you people are not saying anything, let me tell something. Okay. Here is a situation. Shall I discuss this one?
Let's see.
Okay. So here is a situation. Very, very, very easy situation. It was like you have to minimize X2. Problem is to minimize. It is a two variable problem. Fx1 X2 equal to X2. Over what? Now over this x1 less than equal to 1, x2 less than equal to 1. And then again, I have put another condition, x1 less than equal to 2. And there xi greater than equal to 0. This x1 less than equal to 2 is actually unnecessary. So if you draw the figure, this is what is important to us. This is our feasible set. okay. And then x1 less than equal to 2 is an unnecessary constraint. That is fine. But this kind of things can happen. Okay. So when I turn to SLPP, when I write down SLPP, the SLPP or the problem table would look like this one. The basic variable x1, x2, x3. There are three constraints that are given. So accordingly, I will have three extra variables. X5. So, and then I will have B. So what is the first one? First one would say x1 plus an extra variable is equal to 1. And then the second one would say x2 plus an extra variable is equal to 1. And the third one would say x1 plus another extra variable and is equal to 2. This is SLPP. SLPP matrix has rank 3, so we do not have any problem, and I want to minimize x2. This is my problem table. Okay, so BV basic variables, I do not know what are the basic variables right now. Okay, so that I do not know. This is my problem table. Okay, now if you have understood the simplex method, to start the simplex method, you must start with a initial BFS, which is a vertex. So basically, suppose you start with a vertex somewhere here. Okay, if you start with a vertex, then apply simplex method, then simplex method will take from vertex to a nearby vertex traveling via edges only. Okay, it will not go diagonal. It will only travel via edges, so nearby edges it will go, whatever possible. Then it will keep on going, keep on generating table after table until it reaches a minimal BFS. That means geometrically, if you see, you start from a vertex and keep on traveling via edges to new and new vertices until you find a minimum vertex. So that is the idea of simplex table. Now, there is something else. Whenever you stand at a vertex, what you see, remember it was similar discussion actually earlier also. What you see is an affine cone structure there. Okay, if you are standing at this vertex, this is the affine cone structure that you are seeing. Okay, this whole thing. This is the affine cone structure that you see. Whenever you stand at a vertex, so basically that vertex, via those vertices, there will be many hyperplanes passing. And their one side will be containing that T. Okay. Affine cone would be bigger than that T. Okay. Now what happens is that if you are standing at a minimal vertex, and you look at that affine cone, then as for example, this is a minimal vertex, the vertex 1, 0, looking at the function fx equal to x2. So at 1, 0, what is the affine cone? Now, in order to look at the affine cone, you have to look at the hyperplanes passing through them. So that would be this only. At 1, 0, this is the affine cone, this side. Okay, this whole thing. Okay, all these things. This is the affine cone at 1, 0. Okay, if you are looking at 1, 0. And if you are trying to see the simplex table at 1, 0, what you will see is that at 1, 0, the relative cost vector will turn out to be positive. Entry wise greater than equal to 0, non-negative. And basically it means that at this vertex, the function fx equal to x2 is minimized at this vertex over this affine cone. Okay, and that is what you get. For example, why telling all these things? Let me tell, let us draw the simplex table. So 1, 0, the vertex 1, 0 would correspond to which vertex of the SLPP, which BFS of the SLPP. Now to get that, you write 1, 0, then so x3 has to be 0 because x1 plus x3 is equal to 1, and then x2 plus x4 has to be 1, so that is x4 has to be 1 because at 1, 0 x2 is 0, and then x1 plus x5 has to be 2, x1 is equal to 1, so x5 also has to be 1. So I should have the basis involving x1, x4, and x5. Okay. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now that I have x1, x4, x5, I see x4 is having the structure 0, 1, 0. X5 is having the structure 0, 0, 1. So then I want to write the simplex table. So I will write. So now I am trying to write the simplex table. Huh? So to write the simplex table, I must write the same table again. But only thing is that instead of at the place of BB, so I will write x1 in the first place, x4 in the second place, and x5 in the third place, so that already e2 is available below x4 and already e3 is available below x5. So I really do not have to do much of calculation. And b, so I am trying to write the simplex table. Let us do the simplex table. Okay. So in that case, then what I have to do now, under x1, I have to produce e1. So 1, 1 is already there. Only I have to make this fellow 0, the second, at the third place, that I have to make 0. So to do that, I have to subtract the first row from the, so the first row will be as such. I do not have a problem with that. 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. 1. The second row will be as such. I do not have a problem with that. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Only the third row, like I have to subtract first row from it. So it will be 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay. And putting a 0 over here, what I have to do now, I have to do what? Now I have to make the entries of C below the basic variable 0. So it is already there. So this is already 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, so 0. So this is the simplex table. Okay. This is the simplex table at what? Now at this 1, 0. So the point over here is this point only, 1, 0, which is the same as 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. This is the point. Actually, if you see this x1 value is equal to 1, which is actually here. And then x2 and x3 are non-basic variables. See, in the basic variables, we have x1, x4, x5. And if you are talking about a BFS, the non-basic variables are substituted 0, then only we get the basic solution. So the non-basic variables are like x2, x3, they are 0. And x4 is equal to 1 is given here. That is here. And x5 is also 1. So that is how. So what is this table saying? Now this table is the simplex table at this BFS. 1, 0, 0, 1, 1 at this PFS. And it is also telling because C bar is greater than equal to 0, it is also telling that the function is minimum at this point, which we knew. It was actually talking about fx equal to x2 and x2 value is 0 at 1, 0, and it cannot be lower than that. We know that. So therefore, this is fine. So what to observe from here? Now, you standard, I mean, you stood at a point 1, 0, and you evaluated the simplex table, and you saw that C bar is greater than equal to 0. And what is that telling? Now, that is actually telling that over the area of that affine cone, over that area, whatever point X you take, okay, the minimum is attained at 1, 0. It may be attained at 0, 0 also, if like that's a different story and other places, but this is a vertex and the minimum is attained at this place. Okay. So what is that story? The story says that if you are looking at, so the if you are looking at the simplex table at a BFS W, and if C bar is greater than or equal to 0, what you see that the objective function is minimized at W over the affine cone at W, over this big conical cone that you are seeing, not just the T, but the over this big affine cone that contains the T. Okay. As soon as I understand that, I will say, okay, wait a minute. What would have happened had I tried the same thing at the point 2, 0? What would have happened had I tried it at the point 2, 0? Now, see, look, over that affine cone at 2, 0, this is the affine cone at 2, 0, okay? This whole thing. This is the affine cone at 2, 0. Over the affine cone at 2, 0, objective function is minimized at this point 2, 0, because the objective function value is 0 only here. So if you try to write the simplex table here, there also you will see C bar greater than or equal to 0. You try to compute, you will see C bar is greater than or equal to 0. It is going to come. And what will happen to B bar? Now look, B bar is going to tell you what? Now B bar actually tells me what are the values of the basic variable. You saw what happened over here when we wrote the simplex table at 1, 0. We finally got x1 is equal to 1 from here, right? X1 is equal to 1 from here, x4 is equal to 1 from here, and x5 equal to 1 from here. And the non-basic variables are 0. So this table also tells me the point. And so, and what Naha? B bar tells me the values of the basic variables. Non-basic variables anyway will be 0. The basic variables. So what would happen if I compute the simplex table at 2, 0? Now look, 2, 0 is a point which is outside the feasible set. That is correct. 2, 0 is outside the feasible set. Why it is outside the feasible set? Now, because there is another hyperplane which separates 2, 0, which keeps 2, 0 out, namely the hyperplane x1 equal to 1. So in that case, look at that particular hyperplane. If you are looking at that, what was that? Now, so that will be related to x1 equal to 1. But then since x1 is equal to 2 over here, it will force that you will have some value. So if I am trying to do, let me Okay. Since x1 is equal to 2, what it will force, the corresponding point it will force to be 2, 0, minus 1. x3 has to be minus 1 because x1 plus x3 equal to 1. That is coming due to this row only, that x1 less than equal to 1, the corresponding SLPP line is x1 plus x3 equal to 1. Due to that only, that x3 is becoming minus 1. So what will happen is that, and then x4 is equal to 1, x5 will be 0, right? This is the point you will get, 2, 0, minus 1, 1. And if you form the simplex table also, you will see that, okay, I have formed the simplex table. I see that C bar is greater than equal to 0. That means this point, though it is outside the feasible set, it is a minimal corner point. It is not a vertex because it is, not inside the feasible set, but I can call it a corner point. It's a rough word. It is not a standard, this is not a standard word, corner point. I am just using, this is some kind of a corner point, and it is minimal in the sense that the objective function is minimized over the affine cone at this point. But the only problem is that this point is not in T, and that is being illustrated, that is being shown by the simplex table when I see x3 is equal to 1. The basis here will be x1, x3, x4, and x3 equal to minus 1. X1 equal to minus 1. So the dual simplex method says, do one thing in that case. You try to move from that point outside, 2, 0, minimal corner point. It's a minimal kind of corner point. From that point, you try to move to another point, keeping the minimality intact, and try to reach a vertex. That means, so remember what simplex method did. A simplex method always kept, you started with an initial BFS. That means it always kept B bar greater than equal to 0. Only C bar had some negative entries. Then it went through table after table, table after table to make C bar entry wise greater than equal to 0. The moment it obtained a table where C bar was entry wise greater than equal to 0, it said, fine, I have got the minimum. The dual simplex method does the other side. Suppose you are standing at an outside minimal vertex or minimal corner point. So in that case, the simplex table, in the simplex table, C bar will be greater than equal to 0, but B bar will have some negative entries. Okay. So you will have some negative entries under this over here. But these things, the C bar will be greater than equal to 0. So B bar will have some negative entries. And then you will go from table to table, table to table, keeping C bar greater than equal to 0 and trying to make all the entries of B bar greater than equal to 0. That is dual simplex method. So simplex method and dual simplex method, that is the difference. So this is what item B, if you see geometrically, the simplex method starts at a vertex and moves to other vertices via edges until it reaches a minimum. Okay, or says that problem is unbounded or something. So in other words, at every stage of the simplex method, the simplex table has B bar greater than equal to 0. That means the basic variables have value greater than equal to 0. Non-basic variables are anyway equal to 0. So that means you are at a feasible solution. And the method generates table after table until it gets C bar greater than equal to 0. Okay. But the geometrically, the dual simplex method what it will do. Now it will start at a minimal corner point like 20 or something, maybe a bit far away. Okay. And then it will move to from one minimal corner point to another minimal corner point and trying to coming towards T. Okay. And it is minimal at which the objective function is minimum over the affine cone, that is keeping C bar greater. C bar is greater than equal to 0. So it is outside the feasible set and it tries to reach a minimal vertex via a sequence of minimal corner points. So in other words, at every stage of the dual simplex method, the simplex table, not the simple table, but the simplex table has C bar greater than equal to 0 and the method generates table after table until it reaches B bar greater than equal to 0. The moment you have B bar greater than equal to 0, you know it is a BFS. And also if you have C bar greater than 0, then you know it is a minimal BFS. That's the dual simplex method. Okay, so I will illustrate this dual simplex method. This same problem and another problem in the next class. So yeah, that is about the dual simplex method. I will stop here. You can ask me your doubts or anything. You please contact your class representatives. For a week, if you want to ask me 4-5 exercises or this solution, that solution, or personally, if you have progressed in a particular exercise, you can show it to me. Once I see that, I can send you the solution, whatever I have. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Should we, if you want to approach you personally, should we approach you over email through Teams chat? How should we send you messages?
You can send me, you can send me via my this thing also. My phone number also, you can WhatsApp me if you want, or you can write email 9954497 95. You can form a group of like all these 190 students. You can ask in WhatsApp, you add me, ask your doubts there, I can try to clear then and there, everybody can see it. You give me time. I am not very good, very quick in these things, but I will do. Definitely, I will respond.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Sir, I had a question.
Mm.
Sir, given a BFS, we did not get a unique basis, but can we guarantee that the basis will be a permutation of a given set of variables?
Basis will be, look, basis comes from where? Now you have to select a set of linearly independent columns for that. Okay, so suppose I have a BFS W, and W has, suppose it is, we are talking about rank 5, but W has already 3 and rest of them are 0. Okay, something like that, maybe another 0 or something. Okay. So since there are 3 positive values, those columns, that is the column 1, column 2, column 3, so that is x1, x2, x3 are permanent members of the basis. Whatever basis you are going to form, they will be there. Okay. And out of the other zeros, okay, you can select few more, two more, if it is that you have to make rank 5. So there they can, they can come. If I see that there are, all of them are, let's say, linearly, from there, if I choose any two of them, they are linearly independent, then it will be for choose two ways.
Yes, sir, I get that. And if we choose such a basis, then can we guarantee that this
vertex?
BFS, I mean,
any basis. See, it what will happen? See, the moment you are choosing the, let's say I choose x1, x2, x3, And suppose I choose X4 and X5. I do not know whatever it is. But in B inverse B, it is going to give me X1 is equal to 1, X2 is equal to 2, this is equal to 3, and this is going to give me 0, 0. And the rest of them are the same non-basic, because they are non-basic variable, they will be 0, 0 anyway. So the point will remain the same, independent of what basis you choose, point will remain the same. It's the same fixed physical point, and it is a vertex.
Okay, so given that we take the linearly independent columns covering all the positive entries, then we are bound that we'll be getting this.
You will be getting the same solution. It is just that, because see, what this solution says, it says that corresponding to this rank 5, this thing, AX equal to B, linear system. So what solution you will get? Now I will get the same solution. There is no other way.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. I get that.
So you will get the same solution. The only thing is that you can ask me. If I try, so suppose I try the basis X1, X2, X3, X4, X5, and my friend tries the basis X1, X2, X3, let's say X5, X6. And we'll get two different simplex table, fine, because the C bar will be changing. Is it guaranteed that both the C bars will be, suppose that this is a minimal BFS. Is it guaranteed that both the C bars will be greater than or equal to zero? The answer is no. But one basis, with respect to one basis, it will be definitely greater than or equal to zero. And that is guaranteed by Blunt's rule.
Yes, sir. Now I get what you want to say.
Okay. Anything else you want to ask?
Sir, can you share some information about the upcoming midterm exam? Like, if it will be conducted on a platform, say, which takes a live audio or video feed, then we have to arrange for a good internet connection by then.
True. I think we got a notice from the academic section saying that it has been decided by the institute that the midterm and end-sem will be where it is like proctored. So that basically means it will be with video only. Kodtantra. It will be using that. So that means I think it will be using video only. It will be proctored. Whereas I would have preferred this way. If you are sending me the PDF file, I can evaluate it. It will be late for me. What is that? That is to ensure that if people are not cheating. But I rather believe what you, I mean, if you promise that you are not cheating, that is good enough for me. But anyway, that is decided by the institute. Midterm and end-sem will definitely be in Kodtantra, and it will be proctored. They will be seeing you. They will want to see you.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Anything else? Do you want the midterm time to be more?
Yes, sir.
I am the branch representative of CSE. I'll just discuss it in our group.
Yeah, please. And that will be very nice, because I want you people to do it. I also want to give more time. You want 3 hours, I can give 3 hours. All you have to promise that you will not look at anybody's answer script. You want time, I can give time. But you do not, I mean, you remain honest. That's all I want. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me stop here then.